Okay, so let's start discussion about the multi-phase flows. Okay, so when we talk about the multi-phase flows, inside the open form, couple of options available in terms of different class of the solvers. So let's first explore what different solvers is available when we talk about the multi-phase flows. So let's go to the application solver area and multi-phase flows. Okay, so here we have a couple of nice solvers available like Interform. So that we aware that Interform is VOF based solver. Okay, so solver for two incompressible isothermal immersed fluid using the VOF technique. Okay, we try to look at the how the two fluid is interacting at the interface and how the free surface is created and all these things we try to look at with the help of the Interform. When we talk about the Interform, we have a laminar runs and LES modeling enabled. Okay, so that is a very nice applications as far as VOF is concerned. But VOF and let's say we want mesh moment, then we have to go towards interdynamic form that we try to explore in these discussions. Okay, so solver for two incompressible isothermal immersed fluid using the VOF phase fractional based interface capturing approach with optional mesh motion and mesh topology change including adaptive mesh refinement. Okay, so all this is possible in terms of the inter dynamic form. So that is a very nice solver available inside this. Then inter mixing form available. Okay, so inter mixing form is nothing but solve for three incompressible fluid, two of which are so in place of the two fluid, here we have a three different class of the fluids. Okay, and VOF based capturing is possible. So this is what available in when we talk about intermixing form. Then when we talk about another class of the solver, that is a let's say two phase Eulerian form that we're going to explore in this particular sessions. So what it going to do, solve for a system of two compressible fluid phase with one phase dispersed like gas bubble or a solid particles in the air. Okay, so gas bubble in a let's say liquid. Okay, or let's say solid particles like fluidized bed. Okay, so where fluidized bed and air, so that class of the things we try to explore with the help of the two phase Eulerian form. So Eulerian form, that means we are not going toward the particle tracking, but for the both the phase we say Eulerian approach, and we try to take into account the two-way coupling by taking into account the forces in the momentum equations. Okay, so that is again possible here. Then we have a few more very important solvers that is available like cavitation form, then compressible interform. So this is again very nice solver available where solver for a two compressible non-isothermal immersed fluid using VOF technique. Okay, so that is possible with the help of that. And then we have another solver that is we say interface change form. Okay, so interface change form is a very nice solver for two incompressible isothermal immersed fluid with a phase change like cavitations. Okay, and it is when we say about the interform or interphase change form or interdynamic form, that means it is based on the VOF technique. So we have a VOF also available here. Okay, so this is again another class of the solver. Inside that we also have a dynamic mesh moment capability also possible. Okay, so few aspect one can look at. Then multi-phase Eulerian form is also available. Okay, so that is multi-phase Eulerian form steady state solver for a system of many compressible fluid phase including heat transfer. So two phase Eulerian form, only two fluid possible here, more than two then you go for a multi-phase Eulerian form. Okay, so that is the idea. So reacting Eulerian form. Okay, so inside that we have a couple of few options. Reacting two phase Eulerian form. Okay, where we have a two fluid interacting, but the reactive type of the things environment. Okay, so solver for two system of two compressive fluid phase with a common pressure but otherwise separate property. Type of phase model is run. Important is that phase. Selectable, okay, sorry, phase system is selectable, can optional, no, not I don't want to mean that, but it also have a take into account heat and mass transfer type of capabilities. Okay, so few type of the different class of the solvers available. If you want to look at the complete capability, then go to the user manual. Okay, and here all different class of the solvers mentioned. Okay, compressible interform, compressible multi-phase interform, drift flux form, interform, intermixing form, interface change form, interface change dynamic mesh motion capability. Okay, then potential free surface form, then two liquid mixing form, two phase form. Okay, so that is different class of the solvers that is available inside the open form. So out of this all, we try to take into account only two class of the solvers. One solver is this two phase Eulerian form, and another inside the interform we have a inter dynamic form. So we try to explore couple of tutorial based on these two class of the multi-phase methods. Okay, so that is the idea behind this. Okay, so let's now explore first couple of few aspect here. Okay, then we go towards a little bit detail aspect of it. Okay, so let's start talk about first the two-phase Eulerian form. Okay, so when we talk about the two-phase Eulerian form, so let's first go to that area. Okay, so let me clean this portion. Okay, so two-phase Eulerian form, so let's have a first quick idea what it going to do. So solver for a system of two compressible fluid phase with one phase dispersed. Okay, so first of all, Eulerian form, that means both the phase we have Eulerian approach. Okay, so when we go with the Eulerian approach, what benefit we have as compared to particle tracking? We need not to track each and individual dispersed particles. Okay, so that is its benefit. So it without loading too much to the solver, we able to mimic the same thing in terms of the Eulerian approach. Okay, so that is the idea behind that. So that is one thing we have here. Okay, so when we talk about this multi-phase flows, so before we go exactly and talk about its different aspect, let's explore couple of the things at a solver level, what different aspect we have. Okay, so when we talk about this two-phase Eulerian form, okay, so what we have is a solver for a system of two compressible fluid phase with one phase dispersed. Okay, like gas bubble in a liquid, or let's say solid particle in the air for fluidized bed, so that is possible. Eulerian approach considers solid phase with fluid like behavior without particle tracking, reducing the numerical effort required with a large number of particles. Okay, so then, but when we going to do that, for that what is necessary, we have to introduce a physical definition for the particle stress tensor to provide a mathematical closure. Okay, so how the let's say particle and the fluid is interacting with each other, for that we have to take into account certain drag forces and different force configuration into account, and it will help us to take into account the loading from solid side to the fluid side and from fluid side to the solid sides. Okay, so when we talk about this, we work with the Eulerian solver, and based on the assumption of tracking both phase as interpenetrating continuum. Okay, so both the phase is interpenetrating. Okay, that means one phase try to influence another phase, and another phase also try to influence the parent phase. What it mean? We have primary phase, let's say as a air, and on the primary phase we have a second phase is, let's say, dispersed particle. So air, because of the air motion, solid particle that is lighter in weight try to move along the carrier fluid. But when that is happening, it is called one way coupling. Okay, if we look at the other way, that means when the also the drag forces is come back towards the let's say fluid side or the primary fluid side, then it is called the two way coupling. And when we talk about the collision model, like particle collision take into account, and because of that how the entire behavior is happening, it is called the multi way coupling. Okay, so all this thing is take into account with the help of the different class of the let's say force models. Okay, so that is what going to do here. So certain assumption we take, let's say we have a alpha S and alpha gas. Okay, solid and gas, or alpha 1 and alpha 2, summation is equal to 1. Okay, so total volume fraction going to be 1. So that is what we have to take into account. And for the continuity equations, we say alpha take into account, okay, del by del t, alpha k, rho k, and same way another term, okay. Same way momentum equation also, we have a phase wise alpha. Alpha is take into account, okay. So this is what we have. For per phase, we have a multiple equations that we're going to solve. Okay, so let's say phase one equation, phase two, another equations. Okay, and with the help of this term, we try to take into account different forces like drag force, then lift force, turbulent dispersion force, and volume lubrication force. Okay, so all these forces take into account inside the momentum equations. Okay, so based on our requirement, we try to tune these forces, and it will affect both the phases. That is the idea. Okay, so when we talk about this multi-phase flows, so kinetic theories suggest few regime. In that particular regime, some class of the phenomena going to happen. So three, it depending on the let's say solid particles concentration, we have a different class of the regime. One is called kinetic regime, where particle present in a diluted state. Okay, so not too much particle present, so it is called kinetic regime. Okay, then collision regime, particle present in a higher concentration with a collisions. Okay, so diluted regime, kinetic regime. Okay, so normally what we say, the parent fluid is more predominantly affecting the solid particles. Okay, so that is what we can see is a diluted state. Okay, collision regime, where collision is also going to happen, and because of that, it try to enforce certain class of the forces on the fluid side as well. Okay, then frictional regime, particle present in a very high concentration with a frictional effect. Okay, so that is another class of the regime. Okay, but normally let's say if we talk about this first two regime, okay, so for that, what we see is that gangular flow theory by the Godespo and Lund give us the very nice closer problem for both to cover this both the regimes. Okay, so we try to explore from the coding side how it is coded and all these things later on. Okay, then here we have a volume fractions like alpha. Okay, so we have to solve the equation for alpha, and for that we going to use the MULES, multidimensional universal limiter with explicit solution class of the schemes. Okay, so it is an iterative implementation of flux corrected transport technique used to guaranteed boundness in the solution of hyperbolic equations. So we require the boundness in the volume fractions, so for that we're going to use these schemes. Okay, it compute the corrected flux between the higher and the lower order scheme based on the weight factor. Okay, so depending on the weight factor, it try to take into account the higher order and the lower order schemes and try to give us the certain ideas about that. Okay, so this is the few things about the two phase Eulerian form. Now let's look at the coding part. Okay, how exactly and what different aspect we have. So what exactly we see, it is the we require the two phase system. So for that we have okay, it is compressible base solver, so definitely we have a compressible turbulent model enable. Okay, pimple base algorithm, so pimple control we have. Okay, then this is create mesh, find create field. So let's first look at the create field, what exactly we have inside the create field. Okay, so look, depending on the different phase. Okay, so we have a phase 1 and 2. Okay, so phase 1 and 2, and this phase we try to define inside the our transport property area. What is the phases we have? So phase 1, 2, we segregate, then concentration of phase 1 and 2. Okay, then vector, that is velocity for phase 1 and 2. Okay, so like that way we are discrete using the different phase. Then we read the thermophysical properties for phase 1 and 2. Okay, then we have a dynamic pressures. Okay, so then we have a, okay, this is again the kinetic energy for the energy equations for phase 1 and 2. So this is all the things is available inside the create field. Then create MRF, that take into account the correlative forces. If you don't want to exactly go toward the sliding mesh, then this take us into account the MRF class of the things, okay, then here if we look at, okay, so from this side, okay, so PUF U equations, okay, so let me guide you toward that, all the equations. So PUF, and let me come first U equations, okay, so this is the our first okay, before that we supposed to have a correct ddt p equation later on. Wait a minute, we have to take into account the different rows, okay, so that we try to take into account in the U equation only. Yeah, okay, so U equations, okay, so depending on the different phase we have a velocity upgrade. But please understand, in the U equation we are not solving the U equations, we are constructing the equations, okay, so we are not solving the U equations in this area, okay, we only constructed the matrix, okay, and then we go toward the P equations, okay, and inside the P equations we try to solve the equations, okay, so that is what we're going to do here. So if you are interested in detailed understanding about this, then very nice paper is published by one of the author, okay, so I will share that paper with you and try to look at the detailed aspect of the coding, okay, so that is possible, okay, so this is where we try to solve entire the U equations, okay, so and then at the end we try to update the pressures, forces, okay, so that is what going to happen here. Then we have a one more directory PU, okay, so again come back to this area, okay, so this is different sets of all the equations we're going to solve here, okay, but idea is that when we talk about this two-phase Euler and model, okay, so we have a different class of interfacial modeling, like how the different phase is interacting with each other, that modeling like Godespo or Louis or Winley type of the two-phase drag model, so all this thing is coded inside this area, okay, so this is the drag models, so here you will see when you drag models, Selring drag models, or okay, and then Godespo drag models, all these models what we're going to sometime required, it's all coded inside of this area, okay, so let's say you want to develop your own new models, you have to fetch this one library, okay, and modify one of the models and you go ahead and finish the task, okay, so when we talk about this Godespo type of the models, it's nothing but Wendley and Ergun type of that mixture of these two class of the model, so straight away try to compute from this area, okay, so this is what we see from this side, so different models options is available, and based on this keyword you can select the models whatever you required, so when we go towards the tutorial you I will show you where exactly you can tune these models, okay, and based on the model you can based on selection of the name you can activate different class of the models, okay, so let me quickly show you, so let me show you that paper what I was telling to you, okay, so in this they explain very nicely about the two-phase approach, okay, so that is based on the open form platform, so you also try to look at this paper, okay, so where they gave the very detailed aspect, but this is what gas particle interaction, so for that let's say you want to use the Godespo class of the models, so for that it is available here, and it is nothing but the combination of two things, okay, sorry, yeah, it is combination of two models, okay, so based on the alpha c critical alpha, okay, it try to mimic the different class of the models, okay, and CD is the drag coefficients, and for that we try to rely on different class of the equations. So that is if you check here, okay, so all this thing is coded inside of this. Okay, so mainly, and let me show you this as well. So this is what one can tune based on your requirement. Okay, so based on your requirement you can tune these parameters and try to code your own new drag model as well if you required. Okay, so this is how it is coded inside the solvers. Okay, so go through it, and if you want you can modify based on your requirement, but this is how one can check the interaction phase interfacial models or phase interaction models. Okay, so that is all available inside of this. So couple of models that is normally people use in the two phase Eulerian approach is most of the models is available, but some different class of model if not available, like based on the temperature or few more aspect, then you have to code by your own ways. Okay, then lift models also available. Okay, so drag models, lift models, okay, heat transfer models. Okay, so normally this people normally use this class of the models for heat transfer Marshall models. Okay, so that is also available. Okay, so few aspect you can find out how exactly it is affecting. Okay, so these things is available inside the solver area, and inside the solver area two phase Eulerian form, there itself you can see the interfacial models and all different class of the models. If you want to tune it, you can tune and adapt the certain models from here and tune for your own requirement. Okay, now let's go towards the tutorial aspect of it. Okay, so let me quickly go towards the tutorial area. Okay, so let's go to tutorial area. Okay, and two phase Eulerian form, and here we try to solve two different class of the tutorial. One is the fluidized bed type of this tutorial. Okay, so first let's go towards fluidized bed class of the tutorials. Okay, so let me first create the environment here. Okay, so we going to use the release version. Okay, first clean the case. Okay, block mesh. Okay, so let's say this is a fluidized bed. Okay, and what we're going to do in certain area, we try to assign the volume fractions. Okay, and then we try to solve the system and such a way that we have a mimic of the fluidized bed class of the things. Okay, so from where in the fluidized bed, what happened, we have a sand, and then from the bottom let's say we issue the air, and how the sand is bubbling inside of the bed, it is called fluidized bed type of the. So that is a fluidized bed based combustions also available. Okay, so there it has a certain class of the applications. Okay, so for that the fluidized bed is normally used. Okay, so first let me initialize the our original air and particle file into zeroth folder. So if you, that means if you go now to the zero area and look at the particle and air phase. Okay, so you will see everything is calculated from inside. Now we, what we're going to do, we try to use the set field as a utility to set the volume fractions. Okay, so default volume fractions for air is 1 and for particle is 0. Now we define the this particular box. Okay, and within this box what we see that 40% is the particles and 60% is the air. Okay, within this particular box. Okay, so let's say set field, and now check the paraform. So it gives us the idea about all this thing. So what exactly happened within this area. Okay,
So here we have a 60% air, and in this area we have a 100% air. But in this, where we have 60% air, if you look at alpha for particle, we have a 40% of particle in this area, and in this area 0% particle. Okay, so this is how we construct the beds. Okay, so this this portion, okay, so it is up to, let me activate the axis, something like 0.4. okay, up to 0.4, this area we fill with the 40% of the particle and 60% of the air. That is what we set by this volume fractions. Okay, now we set the volume fractions, so few more things we have to set inside the thermophysical properties and all these things. So definitely gravitational term we have to activate, okay, to take into account the body forces. Okay, so it is available. Phase properties, so we have a phases, particle phase and air phase. Okay, so two phase we take into account. Okay, and then we have a particle, so we have a diameter of the particles. Okay, so what is the size of the particle diameter we require, that is we are take into account. Then alpha maximum, how much is the maximum, and the residual alpha, it's that is relaxations. Okay, so that is what we are setting from this entry. Okay, then for similar line for air also, we have a all these entries like residuals alpha 0 and residual alpha 0. Okay, and diameter model, we say constant diameter models. Okay, so both the places, and we say the diameter of the particular particles. Then we say blending, we say continuous phase is the air. Okay, and dispersed phase is the particles solid. Then sigma, if we work with the liquid and bubble, then the we have to specify the surface tension. Here we need not to specify. Okay, then the drag model, so that is what exactly I am talking. So particle in air, okay, so particle in air, what different class of the drag models we want to implement, and effect of different drag model one can simulate. Okay, so right now we are working with one class of the drag models. Okay, and for that how the particle behavior is happening and how the particle is loading on the flow system we take into account. Okay, same way heat transfer wise we have Marshall models we take into account. Okay, lift we didn't consider, wall lubrication we didn't consider, turbulent dispersion also we didn't consider. Okay, so based on our requirement, what different class of the source term we have to take into account inside the our momentum equation, we have to activate all this class of the modeling. So this is about the drag force. Okay, then if virtual mass we have anything, then heat transfer, lift force, wall lubrication force, or turbulent dispersion class of the forces. Okay, so all these force, if you were to take into account, we have to specify all these properties inside the phase property area. Now we have a different thermophysical properties for air. Okay, so for air we have a thermophysical properties. Okay, so we are working with H thermo. Okay, and we specifying mu and PR. Same way for particle also, we have thermophysical properties. We have a density CP. Okay, mu equal to zero, but PR we are specifying rho. So out of this, we have to take into account the rho. That is very important quantities, and the CP. Okay, and then for turbulent properties, we say for air we are taking into account the K epsilon models as a Rankine modeling we are using, and for particles we are working with the kinetic theory based modeling. Okay, so kinetic theory based modeling, that means we say viscous model Goddard's Pau. Okay, frictional stress model Johnson's. Okay, so all these settings we have to take into account from the particle side. Okay, so how the particle is behaving when we talk about the turbulent phases. Okay, so this is all the settings one is to take into account inside the this constant folder. So constant folder, we very important file is the phase property files, and then we have a thermophysical property and turbulent properties for air as well as particle phases. Okay, so this is few aspect we have to take into account from the constant area. Okay, now let's go to the zeroth folder. Okay, so in the zero folder we have to assign all these properties. Okay, so out of that ORG is the original file as a backup file. Okay, rest all we have to set. Okay, so let me close this side. Wait. Okay, so it is open. Now start with the air velocity. Okay, so inlet we are specifying. So let me again go to the parafoam and have an idea where is this inlet and outlet. Okay, so patch name, this is inlet and this is outlet. Okay, so that at the inlet we are saying as a phase entering is only alpha. Okay, so phase entered is alpha as air. Okay, and inlet velocity we are specifying the y component. Okay, and also we initialize air velocity as a y component. Then at the outlet we are saying pressure outlet. Okay, and pressure outlet condition we fix. Now let's look at the particle velocity. Okay, so inlet we are not saying any particle is going to enter. From the inlet only the air is going to enter, okay, not the particle is going to enter. Same way temperature side. Okay, so uniform, let's say 600, we initialize with this and inlet and outlet temperature. Okay, same way particles, we say at the outlet we say inlet outlet for the particles temperature. Okay, same way 1 minute at the outlet we say specify the fixed value for particles. Okay, then we have had pressures, so fixed flux pressure conditions we are specifying. Okay, then K and epsilon we have to specify because we are working with the K epsilon models. Okay, then we have a alpha for particle, alpha for T,
alpha for air.
Okay, and then yeah, this is initialized file. Okay, so that is what we need. Okay, so this is all the properties we have to set in the zeroth folder. Okay, now let's go to the this area settings. Okay, so control dict file, two phase oil and form. Okay, and we are working with delta T starting, but we have a chance to adjust the time step based on the current number. So right now we are not doing, we are working with the fixed delta T. Okay, field average, if you want time average quantities you can turn on and turn off based on your requirement. Okay, so right now I am turn off these quantities because first the field established, then we supposed to start this calculation. Then scheme wise already in scheme we are using. Okay, and for all the alphas and everything we working with the one lead type of the schemes. Okay, then Laplacian linear uncorrected. Okay, it is orthogonal mesh, so need not to do any corrections. If it is non-orthogonal we have to go with the corrected schemes. Solutions, here we require the additional solver for alpha. Okay, so if the alpha is not converging well, then we have to increase this alpha subcycles. Okay, and that allow us to increase the convergence of alpha. Okay, then we are right now using with the smoother solver, but you can change smooth to the BICG class of the solvers. Okay, now pimple based algorithm. So we have a outer corrector equal to 3, inner corrector 1. Okay, and relaxation, we didn't relax anything, but if we find the divergence then we have to tune these parameters. Okay, so what I suggest, if you find the divergence, then first I suggest try to increase this pimple loop. Okay, with the pimple loop if you able to stabilize the behavior, then need not to go for under relaxations. Okay, so that is the idea. Okay, so now we are set for calculations. So let's start the run. Okay, so we are set with this everything. If you want to run with in the serial, then we have to run with this command. Now let's first look at the output of this case. Okay, so let's say yeah, time loop start. So relative velocities, it is UR is the relative velocity. Okay, so that is nothing but the velocity between the particle and the fluids. Okay, so that is the relative velocity. okay. MULAS, we are using that scheme to solve the volume fractions, so that is what you will see here. And let me again go to the scheme area, okay, solution area. So solution area, we have a two alpha subcycles, so that is why you are seeing this solve for two time, okay. Then we say solve for alpha particles, okay. Then we have a energy equation for air and particles, okay. So that is what we are doing here. Then we solve for pressures, and from the pressure we straight away calculating the velocities, okay, without exactly solving the velocities, okay. So if you remember, I told you that in this particular file, U file, we only constructing the matrix but not solving the matrix, and that matrix is used in as a for constructing the AP term for the pressure equations, okay. So that is how it going to work. Then alpha particle is a volume fractions, okay, that is you can see from this area, okay. For then let's solve, this is for pimple iteration 1, okay. So this is pimple iteration 1, okay. Then 2, okay. Then we have a 3, so total 3 outer iterations we gave, so that is belong to this area, okay. Then n corrector equal to 1 only, so we don't see multiple pressure correction over there, okay. So that is exactly what happened, okay. So this is how this exactly this value, so we have a only one correctors, okay. So that is what exactly happened, and this is the sequence we solve for alpha volume fractions, okay. And then we solve for energy equations and build up the pressures, and then solve for pressure equations, and then we go for this turbulent equations K and epsilons, okay. So this is how exactly happening, okay. Let me, okay, I already run this case for a longer time and I have a backup for that, okay. So let me quickly show you few aspect here, okay. So this is the fluidized bed, let me first go to the last entry, okay. And we are interested to look at the air, alpha air, that is the volume fraction of air, okay. And this is how you can see slowly, okay, bed is from the bottom, we are releasing the air, okay, and the entire bed is first moving upside, okay, and then it's going to start the bubbling, okay. So that is exactly what going to happen. So look, this is the air, alpha air, okay. So let me, better approach is just look at the this thing, alpha of particles, okay. So let's start from here. Okay, now look, in this area what we kept is initialized with the 40% of the particle and 60% of the air. Now we releasing the air from the bottom, and particle is very small in diameter and size, so it is start moving along with the air, okay. And then it's because of the different forces is also coming back, okay, at the, and it's like a bubbling, okay. So this is why it is called the fluidized bed, okay. So bed, but it is like a fluid type of behavior, so all the particle is look like a fluidic in nature, okay. So it is not behave like a very solid particles, but it move along the flow behavior, so that is what one can see. So out of this I have a couple of videos, that is what I generated from these data, okay. So alpha, so this is what we have over a different time, okay. So this is alpha for particles and alpha for air, okay. So this is how the behavior of the particles within the system, but please understand we are not tracking the particle, we are saying it is in the all around frame of reference. Okay, so like always velocity temperature is in all around frame. Okay, in the similar line we are saying the all the solid particle is also in the Eulerian frame. Okay, so for what one can do is right now we are working with one class of the particular models. Okay, that is the drag models or phase interfacial models, but you can go ahead and change the models to different class of the models based on your understanding from the multiphase flows and try to compare the behavior of all these quantities. Okay, here I didn't okay, let me also show you the field averaged flow field from here. Okay, so yeah, I have that aspect as well. So this is all quantities, but let me look at the, wait a minute, I have a U air mean. Yeah, correct. So this is instantaneous U. Okay, and then I'm not able to activate the mean quantities, that's why I'm just checking why here it is showing me U mean and all these things. Okay, so let me activate this only. Air mean, yeah. So this is the mean quantities. Okay, so then P mean, pressure mean. So this is the pre mean, mean pressure, and the air mean velocities. Okay, so that is coming from the mean side. Okay, particle mean I have. Okay, so let's look at the particle mean concentrations. So over a time, what is the concentration of particles within this system, that is what it is showing, in which area what is the particles. So that is we can see as a time average quantities. So wherever we have mean, that is mean to that. And then U particle means, okay, that is also we have. So U particle mean, so this is the mean velocity of the particles. So mean velocity of particles at the max reaching something like 0.7, and if you look at the mean velocity of air, it's going towards 2.14. okay, so that is what we see the difference in between the velocity of air and the particles. So this is the mean, but if you see till it is not exactly symmetric. So if you want the exact symmetric nature, then you have to run for a longer time and you will going to get the mean quantities very nicely out of it. Okay, so this is how one can quickly check the this fluidized bed class of the case. What I now suggesting, go to this area. Okay, and here we have a different class of the models. Okay, so you try to look at the Godespow models. Okay, and try to check. Okay, so if we say, let's say score test, it give us the idea what different class of the models is available in this area. Okay, so let me go back to our first case FG. Now let me first clean that case. Okay, and then we again try to check. So look, for the drag models you have this different variety of model available. Okay, so based on your understanding, try to run this case for different, let's say this Godespow. Okay, and right now we work with one class of the models. Okay, So you can use different class of the models and compare the behavior of this particles within the fluidized bed system. Okay, so that is one thing you quickly check and have a exposure about the different class of the drag models. Okay, so that please check and compare the result between different class of the drag models. You can also change the diameter of the particles. Okay, and when you change the diameter of particles, you can see the different behavior of the particles. Okay, same way you can okay, here surface tension is not important, but when we talk about the liquid and the air, at that time it is important. Okay, then right now we didn't take into account turbulent dispersions or wall lubricant, anything. Okay, lift models also we didn't take into account. Okay, but if you want, you can take into account the lift modeling as well. Okay, and have an idea about this class of the fluidized bed type of the system. Okay, now let's talk about another very interesting tutorial that is called bubble column. Okay, so this fluidized bed and bubble column is the very simple class of the tutorials. So let's explore the next tutorial, bubble column. Okay, and here again first let me clean the case. Okay, and then let's first explore the block mesh. Okay, as well as clean the our original file, then paraform. Okay, and just check, so this is our let's say system or the mesh size. What we're going to do, we try to fill this with the help of the let's say our air and the water. Okay, and then bubble, try to bubble up inside of the system. That is the idea. Okay, so for that we have to use the set field. Okay, so before we go toward the set field area, let's look at the set field. So inside the set field we say everywhere is 1, except in this particular box we say air is going to be 0. Okay, and now before we go toward that, let's look at the all these properties so we have an idea. So G activated, phase we have air and water. Okay, so air we said isothermal models we use for diameter modeling and isothermal coefficients required. Then for the water we say constant bubble diameter for the water, we say that is the size we consider. Blending, okay, so we say linear. And max fully dispersed alpha for air, partially fully dispersed, this is what one can specify. Sigma, that is surface tension between both the things. Okay, and then the drag models here. Okay, so we have air in water and water in air. Both the ways you have to specify the drag models. Okay, so segregated. Okay, so air and, so look, air in water, okay, water in air, and air and water combined. So few aspect we can set in the drag modeling. Okay, then virtual mass about the air and water. Okay, then heat transfer, then lift and all drag and lift, then wall lubrication and the turbulent dispersions. Okay, so this is all different settings about the this bubbling type of the things. Then thermophysical property for air, then water. Okay, then turbulence we are saying laminar. Okay, both the things, air and water, we are saying it, we work with the laminar class of the case. Okay, so now okay, let's look at the first the paraform. Okay, and activate alpha of air. Okay, so that is what we have, and alpha we use the set field, that's why. Okay, so if you say set field, then only we will see the variations of both the phases. Now let's look at the air of air. So look, so just open this set field. Okay, so what we say, everywhere it is one. Okay, so except this area, we are saying everywhere it is one, but in this area, in this box, we say the air equal to zero. That means in this zone, the water is predominantly dominated in this particular area. Okay, so that is how we set the our both the fluid volume fraction within the system. Okay, now let's run this case first. Okay, and have an idea how what is exactly happening within the system. It is running. Meanwhile, let's start the parafoam and check. So we have a alpha of water. Now look, this is the alpha of water. Okay, sorry, not available there. Alpha of air. Okay, so it's right now building up. Okay, so before that, let's check the boundary conditions for each field. So let's start with the air. Okay, so inlet we say fixed value internally calculated. Okay, and for water again fixed value internally calculated at the inlet. Outlet we say pressure inlet outlet. Okay, same way pressure inlet outlet for both the things. Okay, pressures. Okay, so inlet fixed flux pressures. Okay, and then this is calculated. Okay, temperature 300 degree. Okay, T of air, T of water we say 350 degree. Okay, so we have a temperature gradient here. So look, slowly the bubble column going to build up. Okay, so this is the alpha of air and alpha of water. Let me activate from this side. Sorry, I have to so we have alpha of water. Okay, so this is the water alpha and this is the air alpha. So slowly the water inside the water air bubble is bubbling. Okay, so that is what we can see. This is U of water and air. Okay, velocity of air and water you can see from this side, and the temperature. Okay, for air and water. Okay, so this is how one can quickly set up the cases for two phase Eulerian class of the form. Okay, so here both the phases behave as in terms of the Eulerian approach. Okay, and we are not working with the particle tracking based approach. We are working with the Eulerian frame of reference. Okay, and this is how one can set up the test case and set up the different properties of inside the this two-phase Eulerian environment.